Hello students, myself Kailash Chandra Sahu. Today we will discuss the string handling. Last video we have discussed what is about the string, various types of string, about the string, string buffer reader. And today we will discuss the various functions of the string handling. There are various functions which are possess some useful predefined functions to operate and manipulate string data. These functions are listed. Length, CHR80, index of, then index of CHR, then starting index, last index, substring, then two lowercase, two uppercase, replace, concatenate, equals, equal ignore case, compared to, trim, ends with, starts with, and value of. Now we'll discuss one by one all the functions. First we'll discuss the length function. This function is used to return the length of the string. It counts the number of characters including the space, digit, and special characters present in the string. The return data type of the length is int. So the syntax is int variable equal to the corresponding string followed by period length followed by parenthesis. Suppose you have taken the example DPOL school stored in the str, then the length can be calculated like int l, which is stored the variable, equal to str where the DPOL school is stored dot length followed by parenthesis. So the value of I becomes 14. Now we'll discuss the CHR80. The charAdd function is used to return the character from the specific index position. Here the return data type is a character. The syntax: the variable should be declared with a character equal to string dot chr80, then index value, which is a number, then semicolon. The example, if you are storing DPOL school, the variable str, then the third index value of the DPOL school you can use chrch equal to str dot chr80 of 3. Here the ch value becomes p, as the character at third index is p. Here some points you have to remember. Here the index value must not exceed the length of the string, otherwise it will result in an error message, string out of bound. Suppose you have given the program to input a string and print each character in a separate line. You have declared the variable, that means you have declared the class, then the method, scanner class object, then enter a string, then string you have entered, then find the length of the string and declare the variable I and chr, then put in a loop up to 0 to L. Then each character you can find out ch equal to c dot chr80 of I. Then each character will be printed in a different line. Then index of. The index of function is used to return the index value of the first occurrence of the character in a string. It returns an integer value. Then syntax is: the return data type variable should be declared int, that is int variable, equal to string dot index of, then argument should be a character. Then example, if your application you are taking as a value and stored in S, then its index value of p can be find int p equal to S dot index of p, where the return value of the variable p is 1. because the first occurrence of P in the string is 1. If the corresponding character is not present in a string, then it returns minus 1. This is the most important. If the character is not present in a string, then it will return minus 1. Then the last index of. The last index of is used to find the index value of the last occurrence of the character in the string. The return data type is same, that is int. Syntax, the int variable equal to string dot last index of character. Example, the same. If the value is application is stored in the variable s, then if you want to find the position, the last occurrence of the a, then you have to write int n equal to s dot last index of a. Here it returns the 6th to the integer variable n, because the position of the last occurrence of a is a 6. Then substring function is used to extract a set of characters from a given index up to the end of the string. The return data type is string. So here the variable should be declared with a string, then equal to string dot substring, then starting index value semicolon. So here you are writing the variable declared as string s equal to computer, string p equal to s dot substring of 3. The function returns all the characters of the string starting from the third index till end. Hence p equal to putter. Similarly, string substring, that if you have mentioned the two arguments in a substring, that is the starting index and the last index, then this function returns a set of character in a string from start index up to the last index of the string, excluding the character present at the last index. That is the most important. The last index will be excluded. So syntax, the return variable, the data is a string, so it should be declared with a string variable equal to string substring int first index comma int last index. If you are taking the value as Malayalam to the variable s, then string p s dot substring 228, then it will return all the characters from 2 index value to 7. It will return a set of character of the string from the third index up to the 7th index. Hence the value of p will be loyal. Then program, write a program to input any string and print the string in the following pattern. If your input is your computer, then the pattern should come like this. Then you are declaring the, importing the Java utility package, then declaring the class, declaring the method, creating an object of the scanner class, then entering the what and storing in s, then finding the length of the what and store in l, put in a loop that is 0 to l minus 1, then you have to write the system out println s dot substring 0 comma I plus 1, then the output will come as mentioned in the question. Then string to lowercase function is used to convert a given string into the lowercase character. If any character is already in a lowercase or a special character, then it will remain same. The syntax, string variable, because the return data type is string, string variable equal to string to lowercase, then string s computer, then s 2, s is the variable which stores computer, s dot 2 lowercase, then here p will result in computer in small case. Similarly, string to uppercase, It is just opposite to the lowercase. This function is used to convert a given string into the uppercase character. If any character is already in uppercase or a special character, then it will remain same. The string variable equal to string to uppercase. Here, if the computer in small case is stored in a variable string, then string p equal to s dot to uppercase. Here p will result in computer, capital letter. Then string concat. The concat function is used to join two strings together and form a new string. That means here the string is return data type string, string variable equal to string1 dot concat string2. If the first string is computer and second string is the application stored in Y, then Z will be X dot concat of Y. Both the string X and Y will be joined together. Hence, the value of Z will be computer application without any space. String replace. This function is used to replace a character by another character or to replace a string by another string at all its occurrence in the given string. Syntax: string variable equal to string dot replace character to replace comma character to appear, or string variable equal to string replace string to replace comma string to appear. The example given: string s equal to Malayalam, string p equal to s dot replace of a comma x, then all the a will be replaced by x. Here a will be replaced by character x and the output will be mx, lx, yx, lxn. Similarly, if the arguments are string, that means string st equal to the green bottle is in green bag. If you want to replace green by red, then it should be string p equal to st dot replace green within double quote comma red within double quote. Here green will be replaced by red and the output will be the red bottle is in red bag. Equals. This function is used to compare two strings together to check whether they are identical or not. It returns a boolean value. It returns true only when both the strings are same in all respect. They must have the same length and the same order of character. It treats corresponding uppercase and lowercase character differently. It is a case sensitive. So the syntax is return data type is boolean. So syntax boolean variable equal to string 1 dot equals string 2. Example, if string x equal to computer in capital letter, string y equal to computer in small letter, boolean z equal to x dot equals of y, then it returns false because equals function is a case sensitive. Then equal ignore case. This function is used to compare two strings to check whether both are identical or not. After ignoring the case, it returns a boolean type value as true or false. It is not a case sensitive. The syntax boolean variable equal to string 1 dot equals ignore case string 2. Example, string a equal to computer, string v equal to computer in small letter, boolean p equal to a equals ignore case b, system out println p, it will display the value of p as true. Then compare two string. This function is used to compare two strings lexicographically and returns an int type value. It not only checks the equality of the two strings but also checks whether a string is bigger or smaller than the other. It will return 0 if both the strings are the same, a negative value if first string is smaller, and a positive value if the first string is bigger. The return data type is int. So syntax int variable equal to string 1 dot compared to string 2. Example, if you are taking string x equal to capital letter in computer, then string y science in capital letter, then int n equal to x dot compared to, then it compares each character individual. C will compare with the s. The variable n will be assigned a negative value because n equal to minus 16, because the difference of ASCII value of the character C and the character S is minus 16. Then ends with. This function is used to check whether a given string has a specified suffix or not. It returns a Boolean type value, true or false accordingly. The syntax is Boolean variable equal to string 1 dot ends with string 2. Example, string p equal to computer is fun, string b equal to fun, boolean x equal to p dot ends with b. It will return the value true to the variable x. Similarly, starts with. This function is used to check whether the given string has a specified prefix or not. It returns the boolean type value true if the given string is a prefix to another string, otherwise false. Syntax, boolean variable equal to string 1 dot starts with string 2. Example, string s equal to computer is fun, string t equal to yours, then boolean x equal to s starts with of t. It will return false because the string s does not start with yours. Thank you. This is about the string function. We will discuss the programs in the next video on the string functions.